The Savior is waiting to enter your heart. Why don't you let him come in? There's nothing in this world to keep you apart. What is your answer to
We want to thank God by His grace. We are here again today, midweek, to also continue with our series of lectures.
Amen.
We have studied to know that the truth is Christ. And the word is truth. And so we need to study the word in order to know Christ, who is the truth. Alright, so today being our prayer day, we want all of us to stand upon our feet and offer a word of prayer so we can continue with our lectures.
And then Bible,
let us bow our heads.
How sweet the name of Jesus.
You may have a personal request. You may have a wish that the Lord will visit you. I humbly want to plead with you, as eyes are closed and heads are bowed, that you will talk to Jesus silently. So individually, let us silently talk to Jesus and present our expectations to Him.
I pray that you know we are all and your dear and your dear. Kati na misro ani Yesu nkasa amsana abopare atwaso.
Let us pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Let your kingdom come, O God, in our hearts, in our homes, even in the church. Father, let your kingdom come. Glory be to your name, Father. Glory be to your name. Hallowed be thy name. Father, we want to thank you that tonight we have this opportunity to come before you. Many are our afflictions, O Lord. Many are our challenges, emotionally, psychologically, physically. Father, our struggles between the flesh and the spirit. Father, you know it all. But you have said, ask and it shall be given. Seek and you will find. Knock, and I will open the portals of heaven and pour down blessings upon you. Here we stand, O Lord, asking, seeking, and knocking that, Lord, you come down and minister to each and every one of us, meeting us at a point of our needs. That, Lord, as we spend time with you this evening, although we came here heavy laden, we shall leave here with every yoke broken. As your word is about to be spoken, Father, set us free. For it is written, you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Thank you, Father. Take control of this environment. And all souls, let all hearts be subject to your word. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you. Please be seated. In all the dealings that we have had here, we've realized that the Bible says, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. And so when you trust in the Lord and you have studied the word and have come to know the truth, the promise is that the truth shall make you free.
Yes,
and so the most important aspect of what God requires from us is that we would know him, know the word, and live by the truth.
And see, Christopher has said,
And so for tonight, we want to look at truth, the key of salvation. We have also studied from the word that Jesus is coming again. And so in everything that we do, our expectation is that day when the trumpet shall sound. That the roll will be called and our names will be mentioned as well. So we will be with Jesus in the kingdom that is going to prepare for us.
And
so the Bible says that he who says, I know him, and does not keep his commandments,
it's
a liar, and the truth is not in him. And so if you want to be part of those who will be received into that kingdom, then we must know Jesus Christ. We must know the truth and keep the commandments of God. And as we keep the commandments of God, we must bear in mind that the commandments are 10. And so you can't keep 9 and then tell yourself you're a Christian. Or you can't keep 8 and tell yourself I'm a Christian.
And I said, I'm okay.
Rather, by the grace of God, he's expecting that you keep the whole of the 10. But within the 10, there is one among the 10 commandments which actually indicates the creatorship of the Lord. And that actually explicitly tells that Lord created heaven and earth and everything within. God has made that what he sees.
And
so in all the creation, the seal of creation is that very one within the tent. When I talk about the seal, I'm talking about an emblem, a symbol identifying ownership. You see, sometimes when you want to have documentation, and then we want to make sure that the document is legal and valid. Most often a seal is placed on the document. And so that is what God did with the one within the tent. Unfortunately, you cannot see on the board. Brother, this is better. This is the seal of the Republic of Ghana. Wherever you see this symbol, it indicates the authentication of the country named Ghana. And so God has a seal in all the things that he created. And to ensure that human beings would understand and know this seal,
the
Bible says that God sent angels from heaven. That is what John saw in the book of Revelation.
He
says, then I saw another angel flying in the midst of heaven.
What's going on?
Having people saying with a loud voice. They are saying that fear God and give glory to Him.
So you
for the hour of His judgment has come. And worship Him who made heaven and earth and the sea and the springs of water. As I see, so this is an indication that God wants human beings, beings that He created, to realize that they need not worship any image, but He is God who created heaven and earth alone.
And look at the one group on myself. Now, what do you know? Or look at the other one, you're so good for me. I ever come.
And so the angels daily sing by saying that you are worthy, O Lord, to receive glory and honor and power, for you created all things, and by your will they exist and were created.
And when I'm a father, I'll come out. Which is what you told me, I'm ordained, and when I'm what I always say, now I'll test that.
And so the Bible indicates that Jesus Christ, everything was created through Him and by Him.
Now, when I say yes, Christo, I didn't have to
know. And so Colossians 1:16 says that, for by Him, Jesus, all things were created.
Yes, and I want to know what the woman is about.
And so, deep within the Decalogue, that is the Ten Commandments, we see the heart of God's law indicating that He created heaven and earth. And that one tells everything about creation. And it is the fourth of the commandment. And giving the commandment number four, He says, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work.
Then the components here, you may know you may.
But the seventh day is the Sabbath day of the Lord your God.
So do so in the end.
Continue by saying, in it you shall do no work, nor your son, your daughter, your male servant, your female servant, your cattle, your stranger who is even within your gates.
But see, and you may be of the people of and my money, the
Bible says that for in 6 days the Lord made the heavens and the earth. And all that is in them, and rested the seventh day. Therefore, the Lord blessed the Sabbath day and hallowed it.
And so,
friends, the Bible tells us that in giving the Ten Commandments, God ensured that He would make mankind, humankind, to understand that He created heaven and earth, and therefore, if there is time for worship, He alone must be worshipped. And if we have to worship Him, God is saying that we must worship Him on the seventh day, and we need to remember that day. He made the day holy. He blessed the day. He sanctified the day. So it was different from all the days of creation. It was a special day for the Lord. And that is why He expects mankind to worship on that day. Remember that day to keep it holy. Because the Sabbath is God's last gift to the entire humanity. Because it indicates that God created heaven and earth. It indicates that He has power and authority. And so when you keep the Sabbath, and you remember it, and you celebrate. It indicates that in the beginning, God created heaven and earth. God said, let there be light. And it was light. And then God looked up there and said, let the stars come. And the stars were there. And God made a firmament. And then it was just there. And then also God created water. And separated it from the earth. And then on the earth, and he looked down to the waters and said, let the waters die.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then the Lord said,
let me get it.
Let the earth bring forth living creatures.
As I see any emotions and more mamra.
Then it was there. But on the 60th, God said,
let me get it.
Let us make man in our image. So in the image of God, he created man and woman. So, men and women, God created them.
And remember, Obadiah.
This is recorded in Genesis chapter 1, 26 and 27.
And
interestingly, God prepared a garden to accommodate them. And the Bible says God was visiting them.
What's your mother?
He was teaching them.
No, just
he was instructing them.
No,
he asked them to work within the garden and to keep it very neat.
No,
so God created. That is why we don't need to be lazy. That is why we've got to work.
Because
God did that. Then, that is how heaven and earth were created. When everything expected to be created by God was done. On the seventh day, God ended his work, which he had done. The Bible says he rested on the seventh day from all its work which he had done. Then God blessed the seventh day. God sanctified the seventh day. Because in that day he rested from all the work that he had made. Friends, I want you to take note of that day. God rested. God blessed. God sanctified the seventh day. No other day. Miss the creative days. That God rested and blessed and sanctified and hallowed no other day. Except the seventh day. Throughout the whole of the Old Testament, the Sabbath was a sign between God and his people. You see, God was very particular about this seventh day I'm talking to you about. And so God made that day his resting day. And ensured that every creative being that he has created would also rest on that day. And said it would be a sign indicating that these are my children. So when God called Moses.
You mean for Moses?
And asked him to lead the people of Israel from Egypt to Canaan.
But then the only man and from
he worked a lot of miracles. There were a lot of miracles. But unfortunately, when they got to the desert,
now go to
there was no food. So they began to cry. They needed food on the desert. There was no way they could get food. So the Bible says Moses went to the Lord.
And I was going to
cry unto him that the people need food.
I mean,
God said, wait,
but he came.
I'll bring them food.
No, never.
And then, so God sent food from heaven to the people of Israel.
And I mean, at all, I mean, if we survive by Israel.
The good news was that God said, every family must get to the field and collect the amount for which they can eat for the day.
Now,
if they pick more than they could give, what they could eat for the day,
they say, we ain't you know what? They will hear
by the morning, it had spoiled.
Now say,
but on the 16th,
now this is
listen, 6 days shall gather it. You shall gather it, but on the seventh day, which is the Sabbath, there will be none.
What's it? It doesn't say now. What's it? Once it's up, they put me in the middle of it began to talk.
Then the people went and gathered the food.
Now, of course, you are not me.
But then, the Sabbath morning they were there.
Now, it's like one
point. But the Sabbath morning did not rain. The food did not come.
Man, I'm talking.
Why? Because God asked them to take double that they would need for the Friday, the preparation day.
You know what I'm saying? If you're there, you're there. You know, if you're there, you're there.
A miracle happened because when they took twice of what they needed on Friday, the next Sabbath morning, it was clean, very neat for them to eat.
They said, "Edani ina, so we are supposed to go and offer the man the emperor. If you don't want it, offer me that the emperor."
That was the first sign
indicating that God was very particular about the seventh day.
When you said you can
And the second section was when he was writing the Ten Commandments, he indicated it there. And there he said, the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord your God. Exodus chapter 20, verse 10. So when you study the Bible from the Old Testament, the Bible is very clear that God is particular about the seventh day Sabbath. Now when Jesus came,
and he
also made a statement.
He
said, moreover, I also gave them my Sabbath to be a sign between them and me, that they might know that I am the Lord who sanctifies them. So Jesus said, do not think that I came to destroy the law or the prophets. So Jesus, when he came, he said, I have come to fulfill the law, but not to destroy the law. And so he continues to say that if you also keep the law, then you are also a child of God. However, the book tells that, the Bible says that, Luke chapter 4 verse 16, and Jesus, he came to Nazareth where he had been brought up. And as his custom was, he went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day and stood up for to read.
Now yes,
I humbly want you to understand that Jesus came to keep the Sabbath.
Yes, super.
Good. That is what I want to tell you. And so Jesus kept the Bible Sabbath.
Now yes,
even he being the Son of God,
who
came to die in order to save us from our sins, kept the Sabbath. Let's get up here. He said, if you love me, keep my commandments. John 14, 15. This is Jesus saying that if you love me, keep my commandments. If you keep the commandments, because it is then, you must keep the Sabbath as well. The question is today, why is it that every church contemporary wants to keep the law, but not to keep the Sabbath? After Jesus, before he died, he told the disciples that pray that your flight be not in winter, neither on the Sabbath day.
Yes, you said,
this was foretelling them of what would happen to Jerusalem.
Now, yes,
the persecution that they would go through.
Otara also.
He said, be careful, it doesn't happen on winter. Because when it is winter, you can't fly.
He said,
then be careful, it doesn't happen on the Sabbath day.
And I said,
because when it is Sabbath, you've got to worship the Lord. After Jesus, the apostles kept the Sabbath.
So
after the 13 verse 14, they went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day and they sat down. Again, the Gentiles begged that this words might be preached to them the next Sabbath. On the next Sabbath almost, the whole city came together to hear the word of God. I want to tell you, Jesus kept the Sabbath in the New Testament.
Yes.
I want to tell you, the apostles kept the Sabbath in the New Testament. I want to tell you, Paul kept the Sabbath.
Paul.
And I'm reading from Acts 16, 13. And on the Sabbath day, we went out of the city to the riverside where prayer was customarily made.
Now, if we go to the
reading Acts 18, 4. And he reasoned in the synagogue every Sabbath and persuaded Jews and Greeks. Here we are talking about Paul. I also want to read Revelation, the Bible's last book which calls us to obedience and says that here is the patience of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandment of God and the faith of Jesus.
I say, Ahana, who did you know what's the war? When I will call you upon Emran Simulu, no crack, yes, because we did it. This 7, 10, 9, 1.
Friends, Jesus is coming again.
Yes, we have you.
And he's coming for his children. Those who have read to know that he is the truth. Those who study the word to know that the word is truth. Those who are living according to his commandments. And those who are expecting his second coming again. These are the people who may be called the saints when he comes.
And
these are those who keep the commandment of God. And the Lord endows them the ability by his grace that they may be able to do it. I want to plead with you. Tonight, if you love the Lord Jesus Christ, tonight, if you yearn to be amongst his children who will be given that kingdom, keep the Lord. Celebrate the Sabbath. Be very keen about it. Because God is particular about this thing. So soon, the Lord would come and lead his people to heaven. I pray that you'll be amongst his
people.
For as the new heavens and the new earth which I will make shall remain before me, says the Lord, so shall your descendants and your name will remain.
Verse
23 in Isaiah 66 says that from one moon to another and from one summer to another, all flesh shall come to worship before me, says the Lord. The Lord is saying that the new heavens that is making. The new earth that he's preparing,
and it has over
all his children would come to worship before
him.
And then they worship him on every Sabbath day in the kingdom. My argument is that if you are not able to worship him right here on the Sabbath, how would you worship Sabbath day over there? Because you've got to begin from somewhere and know it. And love it. Then you can continue.
And yet, not what?
And then, if you are even not able to keep it as expected, you can't even get there to celebrate the Sabbath. Friends, I challenge you tonight.
And
if you want to be amongst the saints that will be received by the Lord into the new kingdom, then remember the Sabbath day. And then there is a question to be answered. How can we really be sure of the seventh day? I
really
want to take you to the when Jesus died.
And
because the day Jesus died, Bible says, was a preparation, and the Sabbath was drawing closer.
Bible says, and
the woman who had come with him from Galilee followed after, and he observed the tomb and how his body was laid in it.
Then
they retained and prepared spices and fragrant oils.
And the
Bible says, and they rested on the Sabbath according to the commandments.
So
here we are learning about three wonderful days. The day that Jesus was crucified was a preparation day. And the Sabbath was drawing closer. So we know of the preparation day. We know of the Sabbath. And the woman, Bible says, went and prepared the appointments. And rested on the Sabbath day according to the commandment. And here we are talking about the Ten Commandments of God. Now the third day. Now on the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they and certain other women with them came to the tomb bringing the spirit. such which they had prepared.
Now, I'm not saying I was here. I'm saying that. That's what I'm saying.
So we have 3 days. The preparation day. The Sabbath. And the first day of the week.
And then
the
other time.
The preparation day, as we all know generally, that Jesus was crucified on Friday. But the Bible calls that day the preparation day. Then the Sabbath was drawing closer, so the Sabbath came. And that was the Sabbath day, which Sabbath, Saturday, which you are all aware
of.
And then the next day we learned for the third day was the first day of the week, which we all know very well that it was Sunday.
Friends,
there's nowhere recorded in the Bible that Jesus said we should worship him on the first day of the week. It's not there.
But here Genesis, who said this? Actually, who said? Jesus said, yes, no.
Go home, take your Bible, study your Bible very well, and see if there's even a statement indicating that we ought to worship God on the first day of the week. It's not there.
Confirm. Confirm.
I'm appealing to you today.
And you pray,
if you love the Lord Jesus Christ, if you are interested in your salvation for tomorrow, keep the commandment of God and keep the Sabbath day, which is of the Lord. Not the first day of the week. Not the first day of the week. But celebrate the Sabbath and keep the Sabbath. I'm drawing your attention to the Bible that there are laws of promise. Number one is, Bible says, honor your father and your mother, that your days may be long. So if you honor your father and your mother, the promise is that your days will be long. Then the law of promise number two is that if you turn your foot from the Sabbath, from doing your pleasure on my holy day, and call the Sabbath a delight, the holy of the Lord honorable, and shall honor him not doing your own ways, nor finding your own pleasure, nor speaking your own words, the Bible says that then you will delight yourself in the Lord, and I will cause you to ride upon the high places of the earth and fill you with the heritage of Jacob, your father, and from the mouth of the Lord he has spoken. Bible is saying that if you keep the Sabbath, the Lord is promising.
I am ransomed.
I show you tonight his promises will never fail. He says, if you keep the Sabbath and make it a day of pleasure, a day of delight, you don't do any other business, but you worship the Lord and celebrate the Sabbath. He said he will cause you to ride upon the high places of the earth.
What's it?
He will feed you with the heritage of Jacob. See, it is only the Lord who can bless without a curse. And he blesses you, you will never be in want. That is what the Bible says, the Lord is my shepherd.
The Bible says,
he says that he will give you the heritage of Jacob.
What is Jacob? Who
is Jacob?
Jacob,
what is his heritage?
Jacob.
If today we are talking about Israel,
and they cut Israel,
whether physical or spiritual, it came from Father Jacob.
Israel, Jacob.
If Jesus would come ever,
yes, but
to save. So God is saying that if you keep my Sabbath, I assure you, I promise you,
say so.
And I will lift you beyond expectation. And you'll be a blessing.
Now we shout
hallelujah.
Amen.
I appeal to you tonight.
And you may come from outside.
Let us study the word.
Yes, Joseph.
Let us know the word.
Let
us live by the word. And let us walk with Jesus.
Yes,
he is the truth. He knows what he has in provision for us. Think about it. Don't give room for the devil. Don't follow human choices. But follow Jesus Christ. He loves you. Tonight, I want you to make a choice. Are you choosing the Bible?
Are
you choosing tradition? Are you choosing God's law? Or
are
you choosing human law? Are you choosing Jesus' teaching? Or human
teaching?
Are you choosing divine command?
Or so?
Human
sons,
are you taking the truth
and
the prayer or error? Genuine or counterfeit? God's way or man's way? Tonight, I want to plead with you. This man here,
sir,
is a liar.
True for.
He has deceived the whole world. Because he knows his time is short. And he has put them in a net. I'm waiting for the day of destruction. Don't vote for him.
And
don't choose him.
And
don't submit yourself to him.
And
friends,
and what?
Tonight,
and
choose this man. He is God Jesus. He is the Savior. If you live with him, if he leads you, if you walk with him, if you surrender to this man, heaven will be yours.
Or so,
let Jesus lead you.
My Jesus. Anyway,
he loves you.
Oh no.
He's inviting you tonight.
Or choose that for you.
Keep my day. Keep my day. Keep my Sabbath. Remember my Sabbath day.
Hey.
Surrender to me and be my child. And let that present day be your day.
No,
now rest on that day. His promises are sure.
Now
we
will
never be alone. Friends, he is coming again.
Yes, I used to love you.
He is coming again.
Engineer.
No time to delay.
I really hope you.
I want to appeal to you. Accept Jesus Christ. Make him your Savior.
No one your graduate.
Go by his word. He has the grace abundant for you. He has made provision for you. He will never leave you alone.
No matter
the challenges that will come your way. If you decide for him, he will decide for you. And write your name in the books of heaven. Tonight, I have decided.
My mother said,
it is not going to be easy.
And you imagine,
go through all kinds of challenges.
Oh, how
about you now? And I want to assure you,
his
promises are sure that I will be with you.
No, so
if you go through the waters,
and
if you go through the fire, I will be with you. I shall never leave you alone. And he does it. And he's going to do it for you too.
Now, yes. When
you decide tonight to keep the Lord's Sabbath day,
said your power said you believe a man's
I want to be sure that one.
Michelle was said,
the Lord will lift you.
Never mouth.
He will raise you.
My mouth.
He will bless you.
Oh,
he will make you a king.
Oh my
God. He will make you a queen.
Oh my
God. He will prepare you from the earth.
What's this?
Before the tribulation starts, when the Lord is gone,
but
in the names are mentioned, I assure you tonight,
Michelle was said,
that Jesus will call your name.
Oh,
and even friends. If by that day you have gone even to rest, the Lord will call you by your name and will lift you from your death and you will become a living being to join the saints
and
meeting the Lord in the air.
So
I have decided. This is what the master can do. Then I have decided. How many of you will tonight decide with me that no matter what happens in our lives, we will keep the Sabbath day of the Lord? If you have decided, would you please raise your right hand with me? Oh, hallelujah, God bless you. You shut your hands down and stand up on your feet as we pray together. I have decided to follow Jesus.
The devil knows that Jesus is coming again. The devil is aware that this earth will be destroyed by fire. He knows he will be destroyed by fire. But then he is gathering people, as many as he could, to be burnt with. I'm happy Jesus loves you. And this mystery is being revealed to you tonight. I humbly want to appeal to you. Don't you ever leave this room without fully deciding for Jesus Christ. Don't you ever leave this room by promising the Lord that you will keep the Sabbath, his day of rest, a day of blessed, day that he has sanctified, the day that he has hallowed. Please, decide for Jesus Christ. Surrender your life to him. Let Jesus be the Lord of your life. I plead with you and want to beg you. On the 30th, we are going into the waters for baptism. Decide today that you'll be part of this special occasion. I want to promise you that God is going to wash you from every sin. Every curse will be changed to a blessing. Every misfortune will be another opportunity in your life. Join me into the waters, and your life will never be the same. Jesus loves you. Decide for him. My good Father, I want to thank you tonight. And I want to thank you for your church. I want to thank you for the truth. I want to thank you for this truth which can lead us for eternal life tomorrow. I want to thank you tonight for revealing this mystery to us. Father, I am praying and begging you that you grant us the power of the Holy Spirit, that we shall understand your word, that we can surrender to you. Father, you know your children. Whatever challenges that they are going through, Lord, you can turn hearts and pains to joy and pleasure. You can change circumstances of curse to blessings. I beg you, my Father. I am begging you. I'm pleading with you. Grant your children the peace that they need. Help them that they can celebrate your Sabbath, that your promises will be sure and certain in their lives. Let them know you. Because there is no other time. Please, please, bless your children and bless your church. Help them to decide for 30th that we shall be in the waters to wash our sins again. Commit them into your care. The Lord bless you. The Lord be with you. May he lead you. Till we meet on the Sabbath, I pray that the Spirit of the Lord will protect you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen.